So that indicator is right below the red on E. Got 504 kilometers to this tank. I'm gonna see how many liters I got. I don't even know how many liters that tank holds. And I wanna work out an exact figure for miles per gallon. Okay, I had 60.2 liters. And that brought it right up to the absolute fullest I could get without spilling. Now it's time to do some calculations. I bought some cats off a scrapper just this morning, and it's got a brand new truck now. Must be doing pretty good. Okay, I made sure when I filled up the tank in the first place that it was filled all the way up just the same as that other, what I just showed you. Anyway, so to that 60.2 liters, I got 504.2 kilometers. So what you want to do is work it out to per 100 kilometers, how many liters it went through. So it went through 11.94 liters per 100 kilometers. Okay, so, and you do that just by 60.2 times 100 divided by 504.2, and then that gives you the value of X. So I've got it right here on my BlackBerry. You just hit the BlackBerry tool, and then you go liters per 100 kilometers to miles per gallon. Click that. So I got 19.7 miles per gallon on this turn. Okay, so that's not exactly what I was hoping for, but that was with the smaller tires, and everything is with the smaller tires I got that. So I'm hoping to get some better mileage out of that, and I did have some idle time sitting around waiting for people, so I'm a little disappointed with that, but I'm going to see if it'll do any better than that with a few modifications. I'm wondering if the larger tires are going to make a difference, or if I can put some Lucas oil or Lucas fuel treatment or something like that to boost this up even more. Now, my big trucks, they get about, I'd say about anywhere from 12 to 15, and I wonder if I can better this, so I'm gonna see what I can do. So after some investigation, I saw that this little thing right here came off, and I purposely left it off so I could show you guys, but I tested it out, and it's leaking a little bit here, just enough to cause it to lose some fuel mileage. And I do believe that that's the fuel return line back to the tank. So that would be why I'm not getting as good mileage as I possibly can. And you notice how it's damp in here and then it's dry back there. So I'm slowly losing some diesel. So that would explain why I'm not getting as best of mileage as I can. So I'm really curious to see what I can get out of this. So I'll run another tank of diesel and let you guys know what I'm getting.